So sharks, we have a fear of them. Some of them are big and scary. And our imaginations can kind of go wild where we think about what's lurking in the deep. They do get a bad rap. Most of the species of sharks out there are harmless to us and just an essential part of an ecosystem. We've got lots of nice smaller things like the dogfishes, the sixgill shark, the leopard shark. I believe there's been a basking shark here. Certainly off our coast, you'd get a lot more of the larger species, including the great white. One of the most common sharks encountered on our coast is the salmon shark. They actually look a lot like the great white shark. They're not intending to attack humans. Most often what you hear is that the bite that they take is trying to figure out what you are. Particularly in colder waters where people have gone into the water wearing a wetsuit, you look a lot more like a seal or a sea lion than a person. So they definitely can smell blood in the water from quite a distance. They can also detect everything moving around them. So they're very good at finding prey. There are some sharks that have to continue moving to get the water to pass over their gills for them to breathe. Most sharks can pump water over their gills, so they don't have to be moving. The fastest shark that we know of is the shortfin mako. I've heard that they can get up to 50 kilometers per hour. Sharks have basically teeth in their skin. They're called dermal denticles. If you rub it one direction, it's smooth, but if you rub it the other direction, you're coming up against all those teeth and it'll feel like sandpaper. The Greenland shark, that is like a scavenger that lives in the very deep ocean in the Atlantic, can live over 400 years. We have the sister species to that in the Pacific here called the sleeper shark. It probably is also very long-lived like that. Some of them are, certainly, and usually it's because of our actions. There's something called shark fin soup, where it's a barbaric practice of cutting the fins off of sharks and leaving them to die. They are performing a very important role in the ecosystem. Those top predators are important. If you remove the sharks, the whole ecosystem will be affected and possibly very detrimentally affected.